Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the day three in the series of online lectures organized by the EDGE department, Isabella Thoban College, Lucknow. We shall pray to the Lord, and I request Dr. Nilima Jha to lead us in this.
Let us bow our heads in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you, Lord, for this day. Thank you, Lord, for all the blessings that you have showered upon us, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe, Lord. As we are going through this difficult times, Lord Jesus, I pray for all those, Lord, who are having financial crisis, Lord, that you provide for their needs, Lord Jesus. I pray for all those, Lord, who have lost their near and dear ones during this pandemic, Lord, that you give them your peace and comfort, Lord. Pray, Lord, for all those who are suffering from this terrible virus, Lord, that you stretch forth your healing hand and heal them completely, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe and healthy, Lord. We thank you. Lord, we pray for the solace and we seek your blessings, Lord Jesus, on the heads of this institution, Lord, that you bless them and that
And is there some connectivity issue? So I would now request our principal, Dr. Prakash, to address us all. Dr. Prakash.
Thank you, Dr. Roma. On behalf of Isabella Thoban College, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our resource person for the day, Mr. Sandeep Patil from Satara, Maharashtra, and all the faculty and students who have joined not only from Isabella Thoban College, but from different colleges as well. I also congratulate the Department of BEd for arranging these series of lectures for the purpose of reskilling of teachers for new trends and issues in education. Ever since this pandemic began, we are faced with lots of challenges regarding teaching and learning. And I think teachers are the most hard pressed because students are getting what they need to get, but it is the teachers who have to unlearn and relearn a lot of things, and something that they had never done before. It's an entire paradigm shift and a change of methodology from one kind to the other. So the challenge for teachers is very big, but I'm very happy that all of us have risen to the occasion and we are learning, we are adopting, we are adapting to new methodologies that are required in these times. And though there are so many challenges, struggles, and difficulties, but it has also opened a plethora of opportunities for us. And the BEd department has taken a lead in this. They are organizing these series, calling experts in their fields to talk about the different ways and methods in which we can make online teaching more interesting, more reachable to the students, and also the learning process easier. So once again, I welcome Mr. Sandeep Patil on board from all the way from Maharashtra. Congratulations to Dr. Kapoor and the entire department. You are showing us a lead, not only in organizing this these lectures, but also equipping our teachers to make use of all these new methodologies that are available. So I wish you all the very best for this seminar, and may the deliberations that you have, even after the seminar is over, the question and answer session and the sharing of ideas be very useful for each one of you. So thank you so much and all the very best.
Thank you, Dr. Prakash. The topic for today's lecture is teacher as facilitator. And I request Dr. Archana Kapoor to throw some light on this topic. The successive program of the online lecture series by eminent scholars from national and international sphere on trends and issues in education, organized by the Bachelor of Education Department, Isabella Coban College, Lucknow, India. Today, we are very fortunate to have Sandeep Patil, Assistant Professor and Head, Department of Education, Dahiwadi College, Dahiwadi, Satara, to apprise us on the topic, teacher as a facilitator. We welcome you, Mr. Sandeep Patil, and we thank you for accepting our invitation in such a short time. It is said by Galileo, you cannot teach a man anything. You can only help him discover it within himself. This is the composite role that calls upon many facets of teachers' abilities and common sense. Teachers who facilitate personal growth in students are unique, extraordinary, and worthy of the dedication. It requires a self-assurance, a willingness to share self, to care, to begin a journey, then launch the student on a personal quest which may not be shared. The teacher, perhaps with the student never realizing or appreciating what was given. It is that unqualified and undefinable difference between training and education, bossing and leading, telling and teaching. We should grant the learners some space to let the spirits of creativity and innovation blossom. In other words, learners must get involved into an active participation that would be represented in argumentative discussions and teamwork activities, so that the process of learning becomes comprehensible. The teacher is the most important factor in nation building. Students are a wealth of our country. Various new changes and trends have become inevitable in the field of education. In this global era, the role of a teacher is changing. The teacher should understand and concentrate on the four pillars of education, that is, learning to live, learning to know, learning to do, and learning to be. Teaching and learning are undergoing a massive transformational phase due to this technological change and the pandemic that has set in. And this requires a need to reaffirm our faith in the role of teacher as a facilitator. So today we will come to know in detail and Mr. Sandeep Patil will apprise us with the role of a teacher as a facilitator. Thank you.
Our guest, as you know, our guest for today is Mr. Sandeep Patil, who is a dynamic personality and quite active in the academic field. But I request Dr. Roma Joseph to please introduce him formally in this on this platform.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rajan, and it is indeed a pleasure for us. So first of all, just receive a very warm and hearty good afternoon from all of us. And today we have a very young and dynamic facilitator, master of e-platform and OER, Mr. Sandeep Patil, assistant professor and head, Department of Education, Rayat Shikshan Sanstha, Dahivari College, Dahivari, Satara, Maharashtra. Mr. Patil has extraordinary achievements to his credit, and just to name few of them, let me tell you, he is amongst the world's 37 academicians who were selected and completed online course development for UNESCO OE4BW, that is Online Education for Better World project in year 2018 and 19. He's also amongst world's 80 academicians who were selected and worked as mentor for UNESCO Online Education for Better World in the year 2019-20. Tuva lived and successfully launched 4-week MOOC on MOOCKit platform under UNESCO Online Education for Better World project, presented the work at UNESCO Chair on Open Technologies for Open Learning and Open Educational Resources, Open Education Design Global Meet at University of Nova Gorica, Slovenia in June 2019. He also taught in the entire country in Sven Neptal MOOC entitled Designing Learner-Centric MOOCs, organized by IIT Bombay in 2019. He received 1 international, 1 national, and 3 state-level awards for paper presentations. Now something about his publication. So far, he has published 3 books, 6 chapters in books, and 34 research papers and 55 paper publications. He has successfully completed 16 MOOCs as a learner, and he would be the first one to launch the MOOC in Marathi, performed as resource person in various seminars, conferences, and workshops. I can go on and on and on, Mr. Patil, but it's time for us to thank you and to appreciate your achievements and really to get inspired from all of them. And we are very happy to have you here. So the virtual platform is all yours. We invite you to present today for us.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Roma. It is indeed a great pleasure for me. And in fact, it is my fortune that I am doing something for the institute to which my inspiration, my guide, Dr. Roma Joseph, is working for. Honorable Principal of IT College Lucknow, Dr. Binita Prakash, my inspiration, my guide, Dr. Roma Smart Joseph, all her colleagues, and dear learners. First of all, I would like to appreciate and congratulate Government of Uttar Pradesh for initiating this Mission Nari Shakti, actually. It is dedicated to the empowerment of women. I am understanding, it is about Nari Suraksha, Nari Sanman, and Nari Swabhiman. We are all witnessing the social issues related with women's safety these days. And it all comes to the education, the nurturing of the learners that is required to dedicate ourselves as good citizens, good brothers, good husbands, good fathers, so that not only our family, the entire society should feel safe that we are living in such a climate of harmony and real gender equality. So I welcome and I congratulate you all, the Uttar Pradesh citizens. And at the same time, I expect that we as the teachers, although majority of us are working in this direction, but at the same time, the budding teachers of IT College Lucknow, I appeal to them that they are the torch bearer of this woman empowerment in the future. So please pay focus to this social issue, and particularly I'm really feeling very disappointed that it is happening in the 21st century for which we are belonging. At the same time, I congratulate all the faculty members of BA Department of IT College. We are rigorously working for the teacher training, not only in their own campus, but in these pandemic times, they are working beyond their classrooms, beyond their campuses, and delivering their expertise to the entire nation, not only at the national level, but at the global level. I am witnessing Dr. Roma Joseph's work since last few years. And really, whatever I am doing these days is the output of her inspiration. So I hope this journey of a teacher and a disciple, guru and disciple, continues forever with Dr. Roma. I was really excited to deliver this talk because it is quite close to my heart, not only as it is related with my doctoral research work, but also it is the work that I enjoy the most. It is the work of being a facilitator in the classrooms that really makes me happy. It is the greatest pleasure that I'm witnessing whenever I'm performing as a teacher educator. I really feel that majority of the people, majority of the audience are themselves facilitator because your teacher training department relates with women's teacher training, if I'm not wrong. It is women's BEd department. So these ladies are working as facilitators, not only in the classrooms, but in their real lives also. Because she is a mother, she is a sister, she is a daughter, she is a wife. So she is supporting the students, she is helping, creating a conducive environment and giving priorities to the needs and aspirations of the others, the other family members. So indeed, it is not a new job or new responsibility that I'm talking about to you, all the ladies, but it is the part and parcel of their own lives. It is the role that they are dedicatedly performing right from the beginning of their lives. So as a daughter, as a wife, as a sister, every role you are performing is of a facilitator, is of supporting, promoting, directing the other members. So let me come to the point and start my presentation. If Dr. Roma will provide me the controls, I can share my screen.
Controls are there, you can start sharing. Please do so.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much. Can you see my screen?
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. So today's talk of mine is dedicated to the role of teacher for the 21st century. And it is of the facilitator. Before going to the topic, let me turn around and see whatever happening around us and whatever we are witnessing and are part of. Three common questions that these days we are discussing when will the pandemic end? We'll be having the answer to this question. Am I audible now? That is what I asked Uma at the very beginning of this session. And can you see the question of my, can you see the screen of mine? Was the latest question to Dr. Roma. These are widely asked questions these days because we are living in the pandemic times. And this is the picture everywhere in every family, although it belongs to the kids or although it belongs to the teachers like us. Everywhere you are finding the links, the Zoom meetings, the Google Meets, Geo Meets, all the things that webinars, regular online classes, and all the things. So there are many funny moments, many tragedies occurring to all of us. Even you can see these sites. There are many funny pics that are gathered through. But some of them are really, really worrying, you know, because I have seen one picture. I put specifically.
Webinar.
Hello. Uh-huh. Hello.
Yes, please.
Abhi 25th ke baad.
Some of the clicks are very funny, some of them are very exciting, and some of them are making us worry as the educators of this country. But then also, it is a very good thing that this pandemic has brought to the teaching fraternity, that all of us are working towards empowering ourselves and our learners. Although there are many issues related with infrastructure, technology, but then also we all are trying to do something for ourselves and our learners. It is really a transformation that has happened in these 6-7 months to Indian teachers in particular. So the new alphabet for educators these days, it is about technologies, apps, various links, and various software, which can be open access software, open source softwares, open access to the learners, and using them in our classrooms as much as possible. Because these are the words that are very close to our daily routine, right from YouTube to TED Talks, Padlets, to Zoom meetings, Kahoots and Moodles and all the things. And you are all must be participating in all these things and using these things proficiently. So what is the situation of education these days? It is going on 24/7. Because last night at 2 p.m., my friend from America, with whom I am presenting at one international conference, we are discussing upon the open education movement. So it is going on 24/7. There is no difference of, or there are no hurdles for the world to work together, to collaborate, and to network. So everything, every society from every area, every corner of the world have come together and working together to move ahead in these pandemic times in particular. So these are the terms, these are the terminologies that are getting popularity these days, and they are very common to all of us. These are from online learning to web, to open technologies, to learner engagement, to active involvement, to collaborate, to networking, and blah, 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 blah. So these are very, very familiar to all of us. So before moving to the title, I should ask one question to all of you. What do you mean by 21st century education? See, we have already begun our journey in the 21st century, with almost 2 decades are over. Then also we are thinking about what we specifically require for the 21st century. What our education needs to deliver to empower the learners for. Our education these days is of 3 modes. From face-to-face regular classes to the blended mode for which Dr. Roma specifically emphasizes upon, and the online mode, that is what we are doing these days. So these 3 modes are there and these will be there forever. The only change that will be there is that the face-to-face mode won't be like what it was. It will be purely learner-centric. It won't be like a lecture that will be given and the learners will passively receive. It will be more of a cooperative, collaborative, and learner-initiated face-to-face interaction. So these three modes will be there. And through these three modes, constructivism that we are all working for, where the learner himself or herself creates her own, his or her own knowledge, her own knowledge construction, her own understandings. At the same time, constructionism and connectivism, these are the learning theories that will be also applied in these days because we are working in the digital world of today. So it is about learning environment beyond the control of the learner and to some extent within the control of the teacher-learner relationship. So it is a very complex and very mixed sort of world of that we are witnessing and performing in. But then also this constructivism, constructionism and connectivism, they need specific requirements from a learner. At the same time, we are moving towards the education to be more and more open. Open education movement has already begun and the world, particularly UNESCO, is working in this field. Dr. Roma is also working for OERs and I'm also trying to practice these things like open educational resources, open access, open technologies, and open educational practices. Because in the country like India, where there is scarcity of resources, infrastructure, and where there is a vast diversity in terms of the learner context, open education is the path to move ahead, where everyone will get the learning opportunities for their empowerment and societal upliftment. So what it needs when we are talking about diverse ways of 21st century education, we are expecting various modes and we are moving towards more and more open education. What it will lead to? It will lead to a 21st century learner and how it will be. These are the 21st century skills of a learner that you must be known or familiar with. These are given by the Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development. And it is used these days as a parameter for the 21st century education. Right from the life and career skills to literacy skills and learning and innovation skills, these are demanded. These are demanded from the learner to get to be successful. These are not only skills. These are skills, abilities, and dispositions that are required to successfully move ahead in the 21st century. So, being the 21st century budding teachers, the prospective teachers, you all are required to work in the field of these three domains of skills, abilities, and dispositions. So when we expect our learner to be multifaceted, to be having such type of skills, abilities, and dispositions, the onus lies upon us as teachers of this century. And how we need to be performing, what are the different roles and responsibilities that we need to hold and competently move ahead. These are to engage our learners actively, to excite them. As long as you do not excite the learners, nobody is going to take you seriously and nobody is going to move ahead. So learners don't need anything in their dishes readily. They just need engagement with that content, that resource, that mode of education. but it has to be exciting them. It needs to be entertaining them, and that needs to be given from our side, enabling them to perform their roles, to construct their knowledge. This is the 21st century, so we are not mere dispensers of information. We are enablers to the learners who will themselves construct their knowledge with their understandings. Entertaining to be focused upon in these days, because there are diversity of resources, ways and means to the learners available in the form of various online resources. So we as the teachers need to just encourage them, excite them and entertain them through the courses. Means suppose I'm taking an online class. If suppose I am conducting one collaborative activity in my class or a project outside the class, whatever it may be, but it should appeal to them. It should make them feel that it is very interesting. And as long as interest is not there, nobody will do it by heart. So these are the things that has to be focused, prioritized in the education of today. Most important thing that the education must evoke the thought process of the learner. And then only they can believe to move ahead with rigorous involvement. So evoking their thought process, thinking, make them thinking with involvement of their higher order thinking processes. It is important for construction of their own knowledge and encouraging them not only to get involved, but to continue their learning paths. So engaging, exciting, enabling, entertaining, evoking, and encouraging is the focus of education that needs to be given by the teacher for today. So these are our jobs. These are our top priorities as the learner for this century. We need to engage the learners. We need to make them feel excited about whatever coming to them as a learning package or their learning environment, and making them, enabling them to work, enabling them to believe in themselves, first of all, and to make them work upon that. Entertaining them, not only in the beginning, but throughout the entire learning course, evoking their thought processes so that they can work upon themselves and construct their own understandings and reach to the expected direction. Then encouraging the learners to continue their learning journey. So the answer to these roles and responsibilities is that teachers must be facilitators of the learning. So we need to perform as facilitative teacher. So question comes to our mind that what do you exactly mean by facilitator? The dictionary meaning of this word facilitator is about supporting, is about uplifting, is about making easy things to make easier. Means the facilitative teacher, the teacher as a facilitator, is one who makes the process easier, who creates a learning environment. In this direction, I would like to particularly initially focus upon this word facilitator. It came from the field of psychotherapy and Carl Rogers. You must be knowing the theories of Carl Rogers, humanitarian theories of Carl Rogers. He was the first promoter of this facilitation. So right back in the 60s, he claimed that education in the coming era must promote facilitation, and teacher will be performing as facilitator in the coming times. The time where it was purely orthodox environment of learning was there, and absolutely teacher-centered learning was there. The teacher-centered education was there. Then he claimed that the learner-teacher relationship needs to be prioritized, and teacher will be performing as facilitator was a huge claim. It was just like what Galileo claimed in the field of geography, So such type of, you can say, shocking statements were there, and that was given by Carl Rogers. And slowly but surely, the world understood the importance of teacher-student relationship and the significance to be given to the learner. And we are now living, or moreover, you can say, more precisely, you can say, trying to move towards learner-centric pedagogy. And for that to succeed, whether it may be discovery-based learning, whether it may be online mode, synchronous or asynchronous way, or whether it is a more of a project-based learning, cooperative learning, collaborative learning, one thing is common. It is the role of the teacher. It is of facilitator. So facilitative teacher is the role that we all need to perform in our career as a teacher. It is to make the learning journey easier. It is not to be in the prominent role, but to be in a supportive role. You, nowadays, you must be seeing IPL, Indian Premier League. See, the legends of cricket are there, not in the center stage. They are retired, just like Ricky Ponting, Brian Lara, or Sachin Tendulkar are there in the dugout, but they are not lively playing on the 22 yards. They are supporting the players. Just like that, we are going to make the learners to play on that pitch of learning, and we should move to that supportive role of facilitator. We are in the assistance role. We need to assist them to move ahead, to use, employ their thought process in the journey, use the learning material to provide them the learning surroundings, to enabling them to perform successfully, to understand the learning objectives and move ahead towards achieving them. It is the role of the teacher which enables the learner to construct their own understandings, to guide the learner through the process. It is about directing the learner. It is a twofold role that the teacher needs to perform at the same time. He is more, not only a subject expert, but he is more of a director of the learning process. So as a subject expert, till now, we were working as the teacher, as the lecturers. But these days, in the constructivist and connectivist era of education, we are having twofold role. More prominence is to the role of the teacher as the director for students' learning endeavors. So we are content expert. At the same time, we are director of students' learning. And more prominence should be given to the motivating role. Teacher is more of a supporter and motivator to the learner. We are not going to give them any sort of spoon feeding. It is about making them believe in themselves that they will understand this concept, they will work upon this concept, they will collaborate, they will negotiate, they will communicate and construct their own understandings. They see, there are various types of learning possibilities these days that every teaching fraternity is working upon. It is about discovery-based learning, active learning, project-based learning, even the constructivist mode where cooperative, collaborative strategies are being employed. But there are, these demand the teacher to be a motivator. We are not going to give our opinion in the classrooms or in the online mode. We are just motivating the learners by posing some questions, giving some hints, supporting them, making them believe in themselves by showing them that you can do it, making them believe in themselves, promoting them, encouraging them. So these are the things that need to be prioritized in our working field. Hence, I am again repeating, the teacher is more of a director of learning. For director of learning, what do you mean? It is about providing the learning structures. And learning structures at the same time, giving the direction to the learning process. We will provide them the online structures. You may say that in online structure, what is online mode? What is the learning structure? Through various structures, may it be from synchronous or asynchronous mode, or it may be in the face-to-face form of cooperative and collaborative learning. And blended learning itself will provide all the things, for example, through flipped classroom model. The first and the foremost thing that we shall be thinking upon, deliberating upon, is about the TPACK model. I think it may might be in your syllabi, but then also I need to work up on it. It is about TPACK model. It is technological pedagogical knowledge. So technological pedagogical content knowledge. We do have some sort of content knowledge as a teacher. Everyone do has, they do have. Through the course of BEd, we are taking the pedagogic knowledge. And even before BEd and after during the BEd, some sort of technological knowledge is also provided. The real skill lies in the center, integrating all these three domains to come out with appropriate and required technological, pedagogical content knowledge. It may sound different. Some of the faculty members are also attending this session. It may sound different, but I am claiming that the role of a teacher as a facilitator needs to think of a TPACK model also, because it is at the core of our duty, our entire process of pedagogy, that this TPACK model needs to be thought upon very at the very beginning of our process. Hence, TPACK model is the one which we should think upon, and it should be in the periphery of our context, the learner context that you are all aware of. And whatever we do in terms of content, in terms of pedagogy and technology, should be in line with the context of the learner. So through my research, I have drawn four particular aspects of a facilitative teacher. You may call teacher as a facilitator. I have termed it as facilitative teacher. So it is about four areas or four aspects of a facilitative teacher. The roles and the responsibilities of a facilitative teacher should be developed upon during the pre-service mode that you are going these days, and after completing your BEd in your service, you have to do these things. You have to work upon these aspects at your own professional development initiated by you through various probabilities, through reading, might be it from the using of various online resources or through some online workshops, webinars, or faculty development programs, but you have to work upon all these aspects. These aspects need to be worked upon. First and the foremost, socio-emotional aspect. Socio-emotional, when I talk about the social emotional aspect or attribute, it is about focusing upon teacher-student relationship, because researchers have proven that no technology or no pedagogy is superior to the teacher-student relationship. Means the influence of teacher-student relationship is the most influential on the learning process. So working upon our socio-emotional aspects is the need of the hour. It is more demanded in today's online era, where the learner is at a remote place and you are at a different place. So developing a quality relationship with your learner is very much important, though it may be in the online mode or in a constructivist classroom mode. These attributes are empathy, respect, and appreciation. You know, if we give respect, they will respect us. So believing them, supporting them, appreciating their efforts, making them believe that they can do it is the foundation for a good teacher-student relationship. Empathizing their needs, their problems, their mindsets, their present condition, mental conditions is also a part of a facilitative teacher's job. Motivator. I think it is the most important job, most important priority that we need to work upon is of motivator. Let us motivate not only at the beginning. क्या होता है कि बहुत शुरू में हम अगर कोई online course लेते हैं, if we start the new academic year as a teacher, we are very much fresh, very much enthusiastic, and we just support them and they are also get encouraged to move upon. But at the time goes, there are many constraints and many influencing factors, but then also we must make ourselves believe that motivation should be sustained and it should be persistent. So it should not be at the beginning, it should continue till the completion of that learning process. So it is the role of the teacher as a facilitator, and it is of motivator, more of a motivator. So this is my first focus, that socio-emotional attributes are the first and the foremost area on which we should work upon. Genuineness. Genuineness is about being real to the learners, being what you are, showing what you are to the learners, not being different to them, making them believe that you belong to them. That is more important. In online mode, we are remotely connected to the learners, but at the same time, we should feel for them. Means, for example, in the online classes, let us not start directly with our content. We should first welcome them, cheer them, being a bit informal at the beginning or in between, making some jokes, some fun fun should be added. Means we also like all these things, the fun, the entertainment, getting appreciated. So being genuine. So we respect or we continue with those friends who are genuine. Otherwise, we will throw them out of our core life. So that is the same thing, that the teacher who is more genuine, more friendly, more informal to the learners will be appreciated by the students. And this appreciation directly relates with the learner intensity, learner active involvement. So genuineness is a very important attribute that you should work upon as a coming teacher, upcoming teacher as a facilitator and relationship oriented. See, I'm really, means many a times I'm talking about Dr. Roma, but she's, I think, in my personal life, she's the best facilitative teacher I have ever seen, because every characteristic that I have drawn out and I'm talking about, the example, the illustration, live illustration in front of me comes as Dr. Roma Joseph. She is absolutely relationship oriented. Whenever she teaches me, I'm always feeling that I'm disciple of Dr. Roma. Whenever she teaches me anything, she tries to guide me. Every time, that relationship oriented approach is there. Means she tries to utilize that approach for the benefit of me as a learner. And that is very easy for me to grasp all the things and to believe in that. That is on the basis of that relationship oriented approach. Second area, communicative aspect. We all must be aware that communication is the way through which we can provide whatever we have. If we are not good communicators, we cannot connect with the learners. So communicative aspect is also very important aspect, very important area. Active listener means we should not be only good communicator, effective communicator, but at the same time, we must be able to listen properly to the learners. Attentive observer means it may be an online class, it may be a learning management system course that we are driving, or may it be some classroom collaborative cooperative activities. Everywhere, we must be very attentive. Means in between, if I'm taking an online class, I should not be keeping upon deliberating my topic through presentation. But in between, I must to my learners whether they are passive or active, by posing some questions, by making them to speak something on the topic, whatever she or he had understood, let them speak for it. So it is about being attentive. It is not only about the face-to-face mode. It is about in each mode, these traits do have their prominence or their significance. And introversion, it is the basic skill that we are taught through micro teaching. But then in the larger mode, we need to think about the smart interrogation. This connectivist mode, it is making them learners to work upon for the and their understanding. In that process, in that group process or individualized learning, we should be always having a check. We should be always having doing the monitoring of their learning through smart interrogation. Due to the lack of time, I'm not explaining all the things. It is impossible to explain all the things, but let me move ahead. It is a very important thing that the processes, the online processes or the face-to-face group processes should be also thought of. It is the process aspect where the process management needs to be a very important area of working. Process of cooperative learning, group learning strategies or project-based learnings or online processes of learning. May it be conducting any MOOC or learning management system or a group learning activity in the class. Process management. Management means management of human resources, time, availability of the learners, their constraints. Everything needs to be looked upon and managed by the facilitative teacher. The structure of this learning should align with the learner context. That is what I was highlighting at the time of TPAC. What is the context of the learner? It is to be at the core of entire designing of the process. You are a designer of the process and you are the director of the process. Creating learning environment. That is the main job of a facilitative teacher, is to motivate and create a learning environment. Learning environment, may it be an online mode or regular classrooms where we are working on group processes. Learning environment is the most important thing that is required for a constructivist class, that is required for a connectivist learning, synchronous or asynchronous learning process. So at the same time, we should work upon making the learners be cultivator of shared responsibilities. In online mode also, there are various possibilities of peer support, peer feedback, peer group activities can be created. Some separate groupings can be done and given some sort of activities in even in online mode that can be worked upon to cultivate the shared responsibilities among the learners and feedback. That is the thing that makes you understand the and to make the learner know what, where and how he or she should go ahead. So feedback is a very important thing and we should not neglect that thing from our process. Sorry, it is a professional aspect, but it is written as process. It is the professional attributes. Professionalism, what we Indians lack compared to the Western world is the professionalism. And when I mean professionalism, is being clinical in whatever we are doing. It is being very passionate about whatever we are doing. It is about being using the time, the resources properly and efficiently. It is about being sensitive. It is about being responsible. It is about being resourceful. We are resourceful. I'm not saying that the conventional teacher is not resourceful, but it is going beyond the conventional bracket or borders of a teacher. It is about being resourceful at the personal levels to the learners also. It is about being neutral. We should not when a group process is going on, even in our online classes also, I think it is not our duty to present everything to readily available to the learners, because we are focusing upon making the learners to construct their own knowledge. And for that to happen, we should create such environment, pose such questions and give some such collaborative tasks to the learners that they will work upon it and they will create their own knowledge. And we should not be in a hurry to give our own ideas or give the knowledge to the learners directly. Let them work upon it. Let them think. Let them reflect. Let them use the learning material. Let them collaborate, exchange, and come to the consensus to create the schema of knowledge. And being professional, that I already talked about, it is a very important aspect that very clinically we need to perform is whatever the time and the resources are available, being sensitive, being very matured to whatever the demands of the learners are there, and being very happy, enthusiastic, and polite at the same time. See, everyone is being paid for whatever we are doing. We are not gurus in ancient times that we were doing it for the sole cause of learner development and societal development. We are being paid very handsome salaries these days with the seventh pay commission. But what it needs to do it with by heart. The teacher who do it by heart will always be loved, be adored by the learners. And you must all be agreeing with this. So when we are doing something as our job, it has to be done by heart. And when we do it by heart, we enjoy. And when we enjoy, our learners will enjoy. It is a story that that we used to listen right from the beginning. It is about that cap man, wo topi wala hota hai, wo jungle mein jata hai, aur wo bandar uski topi ya utha ke leke jate hai, aur wo patthar maarte rehta hai, wo ped pe se phal phekte rehte hai. And on the contrary, जब अपने सिर की टोपी वो नीचे उछाल फेंक देता है तो वो भी टोपियां फेंक देते हैं. The same way it is about the teacher-student relationship. If we are annoyed, if we are doing it very mechanically, they will be also passive. If we are doing with passion, commitment, enthusiasm, pleasure, the same way that the learners will correspond. One quotation of Rabindranath Tagore really touched me right from my BA times. As the sun rises, the entire environment, the entire nature gets excited. There is pleasure, there is happiness, joy everywhere. You can feel it. The same way it should be by the entrance of a teacher in a classroom. There should be very, very joyous atmosphere, pleasure, excitement, commitment, happiness should be there. These are the things that cannot be borrowed upon or that cannot be taught in BA curriculum. It should come from within. It comes through practice. It comes through dedication. It comes through your own happiness as an individual. If you are very disturbed at your personal level, how can you teach students with happiness? It is not possible. So be happy with whatever it is there, but do your job as a teacher with dedication and happiness. Live in the present moment, and the time will come that you will get what you desire. So it is about being in the present moment and doing it clinically as a facilitative teacher. Tactfulness. There are various issues in the online context, in online environments, as well as in the regular classroom. Using the resources, using the cues, posing such questions, even making the passive learners to move ahead, understanding, recognizing the process, the progress of each learner. These are the tacks that need to be there with us. These are such type of armory. These are small things, but they make us a great teacher. And small efforts will definitely what you say, they will definitely get integrated in your personality and will be expressed through your performance. And I think these all aspects will be aligned and integrated in your performance when you are doing it by heart. Simple thing is about practicing. Simple thing is about collaborating, because no one is perfect these days. Even there are times when Dr. Roma asks some few suggestions from me, from a very, what you can say, the initial learner. I'm just the initial learner compared to her. I'm just a budding learner compared to Roma ma'am. But then also many times she has discussions with me. So it is about collaborating. It is about reflecting. It is about bringing whatever we have learned into the practice. It is about thinking of the present situation. It is about thinking of our country, our society, our responsibilities as a citizen and as a teacher. And automatically thinking about this thing, our performance will reflect all the attributes. It is about being in practice. Definitely these things will improve one by one day. One by one, definitely the performance will improve. This is a symbol that I have made with the help of my friend who works for the designing. See, it is about what Mahatma Gandhi has said. Facilitative teacher, this symbol reflects the role of a facilitative teacher. And that is what Mahatma Gandhi has said. The role of a teacher is of making the learner to believe in hand, heart, and heads. See, we should make the learners to get engaged. Means it is reflected through the hands. Let them get engaged with the learning material. Let us provide them the opportunities to use their heads, their heart, and their hand. Let them be connected with the learners through hearts. Means socio-emotionally, our development is required. Let us use our brains and provoke the brains of the learners. Let us create such an environment where they can use their brain powers, their higher order thinking processes. And at the same time, let us create such open atmosphere that such birds of thinking will fly. And definitely learning will, the learning process will lead to the end where they will cross your expectations. The learner will be self-motivated. That is what we demand, that we need to create the learners who are self-motivated, develop the learners who are self-motivated. So this is what my thinking was about, and it is reflected through this symbol. And that is what I was eager to explain to you, that let us be performing our duties with passion, commitment. Although there might be differences, there might be ups and downs in our career, there might be differences amongst ourselves in terms of the skills, abilities, but the attitude should not deviate. The attitude should stick to the mission shakti of empowering the students, empowering our societies. And let us all work for that direction, and let us all get over soon, and we once again start our journey in our classrooms. But at the time, we should use this online excellence in the future, beyond pandemic times, to create a competent Atmanirbhar Indian in the future as a teacher. Thank you so much, Honorable Principal Ma'am and Dr. Roma Joseph, for inviting me for this valuable talk series. And I congratulate you learners that you are doing such a wonderful job. Even in these times, you are learning something. That is a great thing. Means it is not imposed. It is initiated by the learners also. And I wish you best luck for your personal as well as professional careers. Thank you. Thank you so much.
ठीक है ठीक
Now is the time for some questions from our participants. If someone would like to ask a question, please unmute yourself and ask. And Dr. Beck is going to facilitate this. Now I invite all the participants to ask questions. They can unmute and ask.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, with very low internet access and technological glitches in the remote areas, how can teachers facilitate efficient learning?
First of all, I would like to say sorry to the organizers because I forgot that there is a time limit to my presentation and there are some questions to be addressed upon. Ek Hindi mein kahawat hai ma'am, jahan chaah hai wahan raah hai. That is what I was really focused when I meant about professional approach and at the same time socio-emotional attributes. See, when we are committed to the to our work, the obstacles, the hurdles do not matter a lot. See, there are many synchronous, asynchronous ways that these days teachers are working on. I had seen the picture of in the social media. I had seen a picture of a teacher who was taking an online class, but due to the low connectivity, he was not able to do it. So he climbed upon a tree and conducted his online class. So it is the passion that will drive your way. And I think when you are eager to do it, the way, the answers will be in your own hands.
Thank you.
Any more questions from the participants?
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, my question is, how can we make online teaching more interactive?
Wow, very expected and very good question, actually. I had illustrated a bit. I tried to illustrate a bit more on the online mode. That is what I said, that if we are conducting an online class, it should not be just a mere presentation that started. We are counting the number of participants and we are trying to conclude well within the time. That should not be the case. It should be more of a learner-initiated online class, where I said that let us start it very informally, just how we communicate to our friends. Hi, how are you? What were you doing? Kya khane mein banaya hai? Kaise ho aap? Yani, it should be very much a familiar environment, a friendly environment at the beginning, so that they will say that, yeah, isme kuch to bhi baat hai. Isme kuch to bhi factor hai jo hame bhata hai. And that pleasing factor is needed in the online classes. But unfortunately, by large, it is missing. It is mere formalities these days are going, and many of you must be complaining, means not about your college, but whatever we are witnessing, whatever we are discussing with the teacher educators across the country, that these are the things that are making the learners boring, because online classes are there. Syllabus is getting completed, but the problem is that for whom the entire process is being conducted, no one is thinking about that. Counterpart is the learner. So the learner-centric approach is missing in these online classes. I'm talking about making more and more learner-centric. So your assignment should be like that. Even your classroom activity should be like that. Means it should be not an online class directly deliberated on the topic. Let us create some sort of informal discussion. Some initiative thought can be given on the topic and make them work at home. Make them work is asynchronously, or making them working in the groups, even through online mode, you can say, even through their own WhatsApp groups can be used, even various online activities can be made. Edmodo is there, Google Classroom is there. This can be used as a supportive means for all these things, and let them come to the consensus and display their and present their knowledge in your own online class. It is not that Dr. Roma Joseph will present something and yes, hame samajh mein aa gaya and the syllabus is over. It is of no use ki hamare bachche abhi ye pandemic time se jab bahar aayenge, schools mein yahi to ho raha hai na ki teachers for the sake of syllabus completion and for the sake of unit test and semester test and all the things, and for their salaries, they are doing the job, but no one is taking care of learners' demands. So it is the involvement of the learner, active engagement of the learner, that is to be prioritized in these online environments. And there are so many possibilities. Making learning management system courses is very efficient job for it. When we think about a learning management system course, chota sa course banaya, aapne ek topic ke upar banaya, no issue. But it should be very much appealing to the learners. So the use of quality resources is one thing, but active engagement of the learner through discussion forums is one thing that will make you make this course valuable. At the same time, jo acha kar rahe hai, jo good perform kar rahe hai, their progress needs to be appreciated through some badges, through some congratulating mails or an informal call in the evening to the learner. Tumne acha kiya. Keep doing this thing, very good thing. And next time, it will be much better if you do it like this. Means usme usko feedback bhi diya jata hai. Feedback is given, and at the same time, whatever the instructions, whatever the modifications we desire can be given. So any online mode can be supported through social media and with other mediums. If we have the deep thinking in that content and that pedagogy come technology. Now, TPAC, whatever I am saying, it is in the line with the TPAC.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for answering our questions. Now, thank you, Carolyn. Now, as we come to the end of the program, all of you know that, and Mr. Patil also gave a reference to Mission Shakti, which has been initiated by the government of Uttar Pradesh. There are many activities which have been planned by the government. And one of the activity which we have to do is taking a pledge, which this pledge is to be taken by parents and brothers of the students. So, main request karungi parents se aur ya abhibhavakon se ki wo apne apne ghar par pledge le, जो कि अभी स्क्रीन पे आपके सामने शेयर की जाएगी. डॉक्टर जोसेफ, प्लीज शेयर द प्लेज फॉर पेरेंट्स.
ओके, शेयरिंग, जस्ट अ मिनट.
भारत के जिम्मेदार नागरिक के रूप में full pledge. She's sharing.
नागरिक के रूप
कि मैं अपने बेटे और बेटी में किसी प्रकार का भेदभाव नहीं करूंगी या करूंगा.
मैं अपने बच्चों को बचपन से ही जीवन के नैतिक मूल्य सिखाऊंगी.
मैं अपनी बेटी को स्वयं की सुरक्षा के लिए कहता हूँ, कहती
उसकी दैनिक गतिविधियों का पूरा ध्यान रखूंगी. अब हमारी छात्राओं के भाई शपथ लेंगे। सब स्टूडेंट्स अपने अपने घर में अपने ब्रदर्स से अपने भाइयों से ये शपथ लेने को कहें, जिसे मैं जिसे हम लोग यहाँ पर पढ़ रहे हैं।
यस मैम।
पढ़िए बच्चे, आप लोग पढ़िए। अभी कौन शपथ को पढ़ रहा था? प्लीज आप पढ़ें। भारत के जिम्मेदार मैं शपथ लेता हूँ कि सदैव बालिकाओं
और महिलाओं का सम्मान करूँगा और उनके अधिकारों की सुरक्षा करूँगा। मैं प्रत्यक्ष
मैं
के रूप
के
अपने कर्तव्यों शब्दों तथा कर्मों बालिका एवं महिला के अधिकारों एवं मर्यादा का नहीं होने दूंगा
एवं मर्यादा का।
मैं शपथ लेता हूँ कि मैं बालिकाओं एवं महिलाओं को उनके विकास के लिए समान अवसर प्रदान करने में अपना पूरा योगदान दूंगा।
विकास के लिए समान अवसर प्रदान करने में अपना पूरा योगदान दूंगा। जय हिंद।
जय हिंद।
जय हिंद। थैंक यू।
आप लोगों का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर टेकिंग द प्लेज एंड वी रियली होप दैट इट विल नॉट बी ओनली द प्लेज टू बी टेकन बाय यू ऑल। आप लोग सब इस प्लेज का पालन भी करेंगे, शपथ का पालन भी करेंगे। नाउ वी हैव कम टू द एंड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम एंड आई विल रिक्वेस्ट मिसेस ए लायल टू प्लीज से वोट ऑफ थैंक्स
on behalf of the faculty and students of the BA department of Isabella for this very enlightening and informative lecture. Our BA students, I'm sure, have been greatly benefited and motivated by it. And Dr. Patil, we look forward to having you again in our midst for more such interactions in the near future. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Thank you, everyone.
So with this, we end the stream on YouTube and end the Zoom meet here. Thank you very much. One.